To understand the building blocks of the universe, scientists conceive of and build machines that have never been built before. That's the case with the Nova experiment, managed by the Department of Energy's Fermilab. This experiment will explore the properties of particles called neutrinos to help us understand the nature of energy, matter, space, and time. Neutrinos could be key to explaining the origin of the universe. They are some of the most abundant particles we know, a billion times more abundant than the particles that make up stars, planets, and people. They are also some of the strangest particles we know. They interact so rarely with other matter that they can zip through the entire Earth as if it weren't there. About 100,000 billion neutrinos pass through you each second. The Nova experiment, one of the largest, most powerful neutrino experiments in the world, will give us a better understanding of these particles than ever before.
It sinks in. It sinks in. It makes you feel that, hey, you know, the whole world's watching, and we are on something special.
Fermilab's accelerators produce the world's most intense beam of high-energy neutrinos. The Nova Detector was designed to catch neutrinos that travel 500 miles straight through the Earth from Fermilab near Chicago to Ash River in northern Minnesota. Because neutrinos interact so rarely with matter, they are extremely difficult to catch. One way to solve this problem is to build a gigantic detector. The Nova Detector is as wide as a basketball court and about twice as long. It is the largest freestanding plastic structure in the world. Filled with 2.5 million gallons of scintillator, a clear liquid that lights up when a particle passes through it, the Nova Detector is ideal to identify neutrinos. Fibers conduct the light to photosensors, and an array of electronics records each particle.
It's gigantic. We're talking about a piece of plastic that's 50 feet wide by 50 feet tall by about 7 or 8 feet thick. It is a giant piece of plastic, and the engineering know-how to get this all to work, it's taken a lot of work and a lot of know-how.
Building a detector as big and complicated as Nova is a challenge. It takes teams of physicists, engineers, technicians, and students from national laboratories, universities, and businesses around the country.
This is kind of the final assembly place for the whole detector. All the other pieces come from all around the country, actually. So the modules themselves are made at the module factory down at the University of Minnesota. The extrusions are made over in Wisconsin and Manitowoc and are shipped to the University of Minnesota. The fiber comes from Japan and is actually tested and then put into the modules. So the big components, the modules, are assembled at the University of Minnesota and then shipped up here. But then there's a lot of smaller components like the electronics and things. Some parts are coming from Fermilab, some are coming from Caltech.
The story of the construction of the Nova Detector starts in Manitowoc, Wisconsin, where workers at ExtruTech Plastic Extruding Company create thousands of plastic tubes that make up the detector.
The Nova project has really lifted ExtruTech to the next level, I believe. It's brought extra expertise into the company that we've hired people from the outside to assist us in both quality control and in the actual process of the panel.
The next chapter takes place at the University of Minnesota in Minneapolis, St. Paul. Here, undergraduates work part-time or seasonally in an assembly plant to transform the tubes into modules and thread them with particle-detecting fibers.
One of my favorite things about this is that it's a big project and that there's all different types of organizations participating in it. Specifically, we are a very unique part of that because we do this work with all students, 250 students, and nobody else is doing that, and it hasn't been done very often where you put this kind of technical work in the hands of undergraduate students.
It's pretty exciting. Being in physics, you know, I'm familiar with all the neutrino projects that are going on, and getting to actually be a part of building something that is part of one of those projects is pretty exciting.
I think that's really important for my major, chemical engineering. Specifically, I don't work with a ton of chemicals, but I think the work is a lot more applicable than, you know, my previous job was a bartender, so it's not as based in science.
The fact that we actually can do something like this, I think just tells you the depth of today's undergraduates. You know, their can-do spirit and their willingness to take on pretty gigantic tasks and really carrying them out to completion and keep carrying them out when you're producing things, when you have to turn out things on a schedule and on a budget, and they can do all that. And I think, to me, that's very hopeful.
The modules go by truck to the Nova Laboratory in Ash River near the Canadian border, where they are glued together into the blocks that make up the full detector.
This is a huge logistics exercise. I mean, to get the materials here, to have all of the collaboration, the people who are doing their little part of the job, to all come together here at the FAR detector building it's amazing that it happens as well as it does.
Filled with liquid scintillator and outfitted with electronics, the Nova detector now catches the neutrinos that travel at almost the speed of light from Fermilab to northern Minnesota. Neutrinos still are some of the least understood components of our universe, but with cutting-edge experiments such as Nova, scientists will unveil, step by step, the neutrino secrets and come closer to answering some of the biggest questions about the nature of our universe.